I mean, everybody in my band's an A-list player. I just don't have time for B-list guys.
It seems like there's about 20 musicians we're talking about that have made every single record that everybody owns.
Hired Gun is, he's like the best of the best. Everybody knows that this guy is an assassin. And nobody will know who he is, but he gets the gig because he's the best available musician that gets hired to go on tour to deliver that music for that artist.
Billy Joel sounded like Billy Joel because of Libby DeVito, the Keith Richards of that band.
You know, the drums are the center of everything. We're the ones that make people get up when they dance.
Billy was so loyal to the band that he turned down George Martin.
We had this interesting chemistry that, you know, just kind of clicked. But I'd heard on the business side, there was a lot of weird vibes going around.
In one nanosecond, your job's over.
You know, if you work for a company that many years, you get a watch and a pension. I didn't even get a phone call.
You got to call these guys and tell them. And he was like, I don't have to do shit. I'm Billy Joel.
I'm walking out there, I'm going, you got 25 feet to save your career. What am I gonna do? I've just seen two guys get fired, and I got fired from the last record. I turn around, I sit down, and I go, ding, something pops into my head.
We were touring Japan. I was a hired gun for $500 a week. Okay, I might have done it for a sandwich.
Pink's looking for a guitar player, man. And he's like, would you be interested? I was like, hell yes, I'd be interested. Because I wanted it so bad. And I just had a feeling about everybody in that room. They had me walk outside, hang out for a few minutes, and they brought me back in. They're like, get the gig, man. We'll see you in a week in Budapest. I was so happy. So, so happy.
Justin's amazing.
A 25-year-old guitar player, lead guitarist for Ozzy's band, Randy Rhoads, is dead along with two other passengers.
Boom. This huge boom out of the middle of nowhere. I've looked out and there's our tour manager on his knees crying, they're gone, they're gone. Going on stage after Randy died, it was just a matter of surviving. I had to move on. It was the toughest decision I've ever made in my whole life, but I had to get joy back in my playing.
You know, I remember seeing Kiss being on the front row, like just standing on a chair, leaning on stage right in front of Ace, and I still remember hitting his platform boot. At the end of the day, we all can still remember that kid in us that saw some band on TV or on stage that said, I want to do that. I think it's really important. You got to keep that alive inside of you. You got to keep the fan in you always there, always alive. When I see little kids down the front, I was going, yeah, that was me. I was one of them kids.
For years, I've been like, I don't want to be a side guy anymore. But how the f*** do you say no to Bon Jovi?
When you're a kid, you're like, I want to be a rock star. I want to be a rock star. I never said that. I always said, I want to be a session guy.
I'll never be as great as I want to be, but I am willing to spend the rest of my life trying to be as great as I can be.
You have to play great all the time. And if you're not great tonight, you may lose your gig tomorrow.
There comes a point when the realization sets in that they're going to be done with me someday. And when they are, I got to get out before that happens.
I might not be the star, but I'm having an amazing time playing drums, touring the world, making money, and supporting other people.
Getting to the top is hard. Staying at the top is virtually impossible.